Good afternoon. Today we're going to learn about propaganda. Before we begin, take a minute and make sure you have your work in order. Have you signed into Gmail? Have you downloaded the notes from the class website and made a copy of the notes so you can write on them? Go through this presentation as much as you need to. Pause when you need to. Go back when you need to. Make this technology work for you. Remember, you can email me at this address and I'll get back to you as quickly as I can. Here we go. The first thing we need to discuss is this word propaganda. The purpose of propaganda is to manipulate, inform, motivate, or persuade using emotion or logically unsound reasoning. Today we're going to talk about the emotion end of propaganda. Now this definition should sound familiar. Propaganda is a subset of rhetoric. It is commonly found in speeches and writings of politicians and lawyers, as well as in advertising. In other words, propaganda is commonly used by experts in convincing people. Here are some numbers to support my statement. Advertisers spend about $200 billion a year on TV advertising. The average cost for a Super Bowl ad is $2.6 million per 30-second spot. The average American watches about 24,000 TV commercials a year. So we are constantly surrounded by people who are motivated monetarily to convince us to buy their products or to support their whatever. So it's important for us to know and recognize propaganda techniques so that we are making informed decisions. Tonight we are going to learn about six propaganda techniques. They are bandwagon, loaded words, testimonial, name-calling, plain folks, and snob appeal. By the end of this lesson, you should be able to identify and define all six. The first technique is bandwagon. The basic theme of bandwagon is that everyone else is buying the product, so you should too. Most people prefer to be in the majority. There are at least two reasons why being in the majority is better than being in the minority. First, the majority is the winner in elections, and because of this, the majority tends to have the power. They get to make the decisions, and that's always better to be making the decisions than not to. Second, most people like to be conformist rather than be vulnerable to criticism for being different. An advertisement that suggests a particular product is widely used motivates non-users to try that product to be like other people. Here are some examples. This Nike ad says, "Just do it. You should do it because everyone else is doing it too." This ad says, "Everyone has it. Everyone needs it." The repetition of the words "everyone" makes this an example of bandwagon. Everyone at the table has it. If you're not using your cell phone, you need to get your cell phone and get on it right now. The last example is this picture of a McDonald's sign. It says over 99 billion served. That 99 billion is bandwagon. Obviously, if 99 billion people think something is good at McDonald's, McDonald's must be doing something right, and you need to hop on board with that. The second example is loaded words. These are words with strong emotional associations. Loaded words are like a loaded baked potato. That will help you remember. Just like that potato comes with lots of extras, loaded words come with lots of extras. It's not just the word itself, but all of the emotions that are associated with that word. Loaded words and phrases have strong emotional implications and involve strongly positive or negative reactions beyond their literal meaning. They are really persuasive because they prey on the human weakness for acting immediately based upon an emotional response without thinking any further. For example, they might get you all riled up and then you act without thinking. All right? Here are some examples. The first example is this Duracell picture, and it says danger, and it associates all the ideas that come with you being in personal physical danger with your batteries running dead. Obviously, you being in personal physical danger is a little bit more important than your batteries dying, but by connecting the two, they're hoping to get you to use your Duracell batteries. In the second example, it says no really intelligent voter would support his candidacy. the loaded word here is intelligent. They're saying that if you aren't intelligent, you support this person, and if you are, you won't support the person. Well, everybody wants to be considered intelligent. Let's take a look at this romance commercial for Ralph Lauren perfume. What they do here is they build this big idea of this big, beautiful romance and then try to associate that with their perfume in hopes that people will buy it.
My romance doesn't have to have a moon in the sky. My romance doesn't need one thing but you.
Obviously, this is a ad that's geared towards women. All right, the next technique is testimonial. In testimonial propaganda, a famous or highly educated person endorses a product. What the technique does is take someone who the audience knows and likes and attempts to transfer the famous person's opinion to the audience. An alternative testimonial is to take a highly educated person and have that person endorse a candidate or product. Now, the highly educated person or the famous person is probably not an expert on the product. They might not even use the product, but by lending their face to it, they help create interest. For example, these are three examples of Tiger Woods on Wheaties boxes. Right, and what Wheaties is hoping is that by associating themselves with the successes of Tiger Woods, they will get more people to buy their product. Let's look at this example of Kobe Bryant endorsing Sprite.
Check it out. To everyone who said I wasn't old enough. To everyone who said I wasn't good enough. Everyone out there who ever booed me, I've got one thing to say.
Oh, yeah.
Right here. Thanks. What's my thirst? Proving them wrong. What's yours?
All right, again, Sprite is hoping to capitalize on Kobe Bryant's successes and his drive to be the best by associating themselves with those things. The next technique is name calling, and I really don't feel like I need to explain this to you guys because you went to kindergarten. Name calling is such an ancient technique that it is frequently identified by its Latin name, ad hominem. That's something you definitely want to know before tomorrow. And the point of name calling is to discredit or embarrass the advertiser's opponent. Sarcasm and ridicule often accompany name calling. For example, in this Burger King ad, we have a Whopper and a Big Mac side by side, and obviously the Whopper is larger, and the text says Big Mac seems more like a medium. Right? This is Burger King kind of taking a shot at Big Mac for calling themselves big when the Whopper is obviously larger. Let's look at this Mac PC commercial.
Hello, I'm a Mac.
And I'm a PC. Hey, Mac, did you hear the good news?
Windows 7 is out, and it's not going to have any of the problems my last operating system had. Trust me.
I feel like I've heard this before, PC.
What? Windows Vista's here, and it's not going to have any of the problems that Windows XP had. It's not going to have any of the problems that Windows ME had. It's not going to have any of the problems that Windows 98 had. It's not going to have any of the problems Windows 95 had. It's not going to have any of the problems Windows 2 had. Trust me. This time it's going to be different. Trust me.
Obviously, Macs are making fun of PCs for promising better products again and again and never really delivering on those promises. Did you notice Justin Long there representing Mac? He stayed the same pretty much. His attire stayed the same throughout the commercial while Mac changed again and again. The next technique is plain folks appeal. Politicians and advertisers attempt to present themselves as just ordinary citizens who can understand and empathize with a listener's concerns. The speaker gives the audience a sense of trust and comfort, believing that the speaker and the audience share common goals. All right, this is just when someone famous pretends to act as if they are ordinary. Here's some examples. This is former mayor of New York City, Rudy Giuliani, at a diner that is obviously not very classy. It's definitely not a fancy restaurant. He's shaking hands and kissing babies, trying to seem like he is a plain person. He's an ordinary person, when we know that his life is not very ordinary. All right, take a look at this bologna commercial.
My bologna has a first name, it's O-S-C-A-R. My bologna has a second name, it's M-A-Y-E-R. Oh, I love to eat it every day. And if you ask me, what I'll say, 'cause Oscar Mayer has a way with B-O-L-O-G-N-A. How's that?
That commercial is so cute. All right, so here we have an ordinary kid doing an ordinary activity like fishing, eating Oscar Mayer. This is Oscar Mayer saying our product is meant for an ordinary family. The last technique is snob appeal. This is where an appeal is made to the authority of the select few, the aristocrats, if you will. Nobody wants to think they are merely one of the vast crowds. Everyone wants to be somebody special. The argument of snob appeal usually follows a strange but predictable path. It says, if you agree with me and buy my product because hardly anybody else is, then you are special because you have something that not everyone else has. While it may sound like a lousy ad and a lousy way to make money, it is really an appeal to everybody's natural urges to distinguish themselves from all the rest. It's an appeal to your inner snob. Now, it's the opposite of bandwagon. Bandwagon says everyone's doing this, so you're doing it too. The snob appeal says only a few people are doing it, and they're really special, so you should be really special too. Okay, let's take a look at these examples. The first example says, those who desire the best of everything invariably ask for Cerebo salt. That phrase, those who desire the best, appeals to the snob. All right, we don't want second best, we want the best. Let's take a look at this Siri commercial.
What's the best way to Santa Cruz, California?
Here are directions to Santa Cruz.
Where's the best barbecue in Kansas City?
Is there a rodeo in Amarillo today? Where are we?
Here's your current location.
How big is the Grand Canyon? Any gas stations we can walk to?
I found two gas stations fairly close to you.
What does Orion look like?
I found this for you.
Remind me to do this again.
Okay, I'll remind you.
All right, notice how the Siri commercial insinuates that people with the iPhone 4s and the Siri apps have awesome vacations, better than normal vacations. Also notice how Siri keeps repeating that she found this for you, for you, for you, as if you were someone special. This appeals to the snob in everyone. All right, folks, that's it. All right, to be prepared for tomorrow, share your notes with me tonight. Remember, if you do this before 10, I will look at them and make comments and share them back with you. Be able to define and give examples of each type of propaganda. Be ready to practice what you have learned tonight. Watch this as many times as you need to. Review your notes as many times as you need to. Review them tonight, review them first thing in class tomorrow. All right, really know this stuff before you come into class. Impress me. Have a good night and make smart decisions.